Have you gone to the man? How are you doing, buddy? You do know that you actually slept the whole night last night? You did. You didn't get up in the middle of the night. You're getting so big. You're helping out the old man too. You don't get much sleep as it is.
We're making a lot of progress, but we're still at it here. We have cleared, I want to say, a quarter of what we have to clear. So there's still a lot left to do. We're going to be out here every day, I think, because we just don't have time. It's the end of September, and I was due to get those trees in September. Now, luckily, this is Jamaica, so nothing happens on time. We're going to get those trees soon. We're in a mad dash to get this done. We're going to take a minute and discuss them. I've had a few people ask, why am I working all the way back here? This is the farthest corner of the property. This is right now where we've got these guys clearing this section. This is going to be a zone 4 timber forest. Once this is done, we're going to come back here for simple maintenance. That's it. A little clearing, a little straightening of the limbs, limbing the trees, organizing them, that sort of thing. That's it. This is not something that's going to take a lot of maintenance. The other part where the food forest is, that's a zone 3. Still, very little maintenance. Normally in permaculture, we say, take a step out your back door and start there. Normally, that's exactly what I would do. The only problem is we don't have a house built here. Without a house, I don't have a back door to start on. And if I start doing work too close to the site where we're going to build the house, run into a serious problem. We're going to have a lot of waste products and a lot of people working that don't necessarily have any idea what I'm doing. So if I plant too close to the house or too close to the building site, I run into a real serious problem of destroying the stuff we planted. We ran into that here with the food forest. Now, those of you that have been with me for a while, you know I did this banana circle a long time ago, and it was doing really nice. And then we had to get this gate put in. And when they came in to put in the gate, they needed to build a road to be able to bring the trucks and the equipment and all the stuff they needed just to put this little gate in. When they did that, they got in here and they destroyed half of this banana circle. If we did this kind of damage to a banana circle, we did that much damage for this floodgate, imagine the kind of damage we'll do with a whole house. That's why I'm not doing anything near the building site. I intentionally came as far away from the building site as I could to get started. Some of you are probably wondering, all right, then why aren't you building the house? What are you doing back here? Why aren't you over on the site getting the site ready and starting construction? Legitimate question. If I had my way, we would be over there spending all our energy building. All right, had my wife not died, that's where we would be right now. Since my wife died, we need to clear the titles on this property. In order to clear the titles, we have to go through the legal process, and I can't resubmit the building plans until the titles are cleared. Once the titles are cleared, I can then resubmit the building plans and get started. But it'll take a few months to get the titles cleared, and then it'll take another few months before I can get permission to start construction. All that being considered, the fact that I need to take a little time to clear the titles on this property before we start construction is not necessarily a bad thing. But while we wait for the legal process to go through, we're putting everything together that we need to do here. Speaking of finishing the estate and getting ready to build, I have to go into town today and meet with a couple people regarding my wife's death. So I've got a few things I have to do. We're gonna get this stuff taken care of. Got that done. At least I'm getting something done. I still have two more things to do, and the problem is I don't have time now. That really killed me time-wise. Someone I know just asked me if I was getting ready for the storm, and I looked at her and I said, what storm? apparently there's a hurricane off to the east headed our way. We are really prepared for storms. I have everything we need. The one thing we do not have is a generator. I think it's time we have to buy a generator. I've been putting it off and putting it off and putting it off. Can't put it off anymore. We're later than I had hoped. I don't know how good this is going to turn out. The light is just barely catching. Take a look at how much we've got here cleared. Definitely showing progress. Slow, you know, every day we get a little bit done.